Africa, hujambo, hola, and akwaba. My name is Sho Madjozi, and you are watching NBA Africa Game Time. As you know, this show is about lifestyle, it's about culture, but most importantly, it's about basketball. And this week is no different. I'm going to be giving you playoff updates. I'm going to be giving you the biggest highlights from this week, and I even have a special surprise for you. Later on, I'll be talking to Nigerian songbird Niniola, Miss Maradona herself, so I'm super excited about that. But for now, let's check out what's been happening around the league. The playoffs are getting hotter by the day. The Golden State Warriors played at home and they definitely did not waste that home court advantage at all. They won both of their games. And in the other three series, each visiting team was able to steal a game on the road. And remember, you can catch the best moments, and that does include Klay Thompson shooting his eye-popping threes live on NBA League Pass. All you have to do is sign up on NBA.com and you can follow your favorite teams and your favorite players all the way to the NBA Finals. Guys, I feel like I'm really dripping this week and you guys haven't said anything about it. Some NBA players also know how to swag out. For example, the Rockets players have been putting together some fire combos this week. Let's check them out. Wow, James Harden color blocking with the shorts. Clint Capela looking like the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Ish, Chris Paul keeping it super clean with the jean to jean vibe. Listen, personally, I'm giving that one to James Harden. I mean, that outfit, I mean, it's too much. You guys let me know who you think had the hardest drip by commenting below. So, other than looking fresh off of the court, these guys have been doing the most on the court as well. Let us check out this week's best plays.
Embiid gets the bucket, a big one.
Horford is excellent. Giannis blocked by Horford. Just watch this.
Numbers in favor of Philly, 31-20.
Game 9, Kawhi Leonard, the rejection. Siakam.
Three by Harden. Right up. His eyes are fine, he says. Uh-huh.
Whoa!
Look at this pass. Harris goes, the reverse.
Oh! Come on, Gary Harris! How did he do that? What a basket! The reverse layup.
And now, one of my favorite things about NBA Africa Game Time, our crossover segment, where we look at amazing basketball stories from across the continent. This time, we're going to Lagos to catch up with NBA Academy point guard Chuku Dali.
My name is Chukwudali Bujogo Kalistus. Welcome to Ibo Newside, Lagos, Nigeria, and I'll be joining the NBA Academy Africa. Let me show you around. We are putting work every morning, my abs, push-ups, and all. That's Kyrie, my role model. I always hang this out right here. When I look at him, his style of play just keeps me going, the way he goes to the basket and stuff.
When he started, I was scared, kind of, because he would tell you he's playing basketball, and sometimes it would take all his time. I'm so proud of him, so proud of him, and we are going to miss him. Everybody is going to miss him in the house, and I wish him all the best in NBA Academy.
What I'm looking up in the most in the NBA Academy, the first thing first to get my grades right, be a better person, and play good basketball. Also, when I make it to the NBA, I want to be a different person, like somebody different, to help the kids in streets like this. Kids who grew up in my kind of place, who know what it means to want something and go for it.
Wow, what an amazing story. Africa really has a really, really, really cool player in Dalu. And I hope that Nigeria is very proud, because I definitely am. One person that is definitely making Nigeria very proud, and that's very, very clear. One of my favorite Afro House sensations and a BET Award nominee. I'm talking about the Queen, Niniola.
How are you, baby girl?
So good. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you for having me in the
absolutely,
studio.
Absolutely. And you are extremely stylish.
Thank you, baby girl.
You always look amazing.
And you too. I love the colors. Green, pink, blue, red.
I paid her to say these things.
No, you didn't.
Please collect a check after this.
I'll collect a check.
What do you think of some of the styles that you've seen basketball players wearing? Or rather, what would you like to see more of in basketball players?
I like what I see already. The very chilled ones are there, but stylish, and the ones that go over the top, but really stylish all the same.
As a musician, like, what do you see in basketball, the sport itself, and the games that you feel like I can relate to this?
Okay, I know for one that they are goal-getters. They need to score goals, teamwork and all of that. And if I'm going to relate that to music, I've always been a winner. Because coming into the business, I told myself, I'm not seeing myself as a woman. I'm seeing myself as an artist. I'm going to get it. I'm going to get it no matter what. So I think that's the relationship that we,
Wow, I really love that. I love that. Just your whole, like, go-getter energy.
Yes, yes. I'm nothing would deter me, that kind of, you know, thing.
I really love that. My team, my favorite team, is Warriors right now.
The Golden State Warriors.
Yes! Yay! Who are doing extremely well. Uh-huh. So those are still my predictions.
Okay.
And you can make your predictions as well. As well as you watching from wherever you're watching from, you can make your predictions. All you have to do is go to nba.com/bracket challenge. So when you make your predictions, you actually stand a chance to win a trip to Paris, which I think
can
is really amazing.
Then
they'll say it's nepotism or they're going to say,
please let me play now.
If you win, guys, listen, everybody stands a fair chance. So if she wins, it won't be because we chose it. Listen, Niniola, most people know your hit song, Maradona. Mm-hmm. I hope that you're going to make one about a basketball player.
Show your basketball at me.
And call it maybe, Stephen Curry. Hey, Stephen Curry.
Boom, boom, boom.
Hey!
Is this how hits are made?
I love it. People know you for that song, and it was a massive, massive hit. Mm-hmm. I think everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
But you've got a new song that is really popping. I actually heard it recently and love it.
Thank you
it's
so
called
much.
Designer. Tell us more about that one.
I walk on like a Gucci. I walk on like a Fendi. I walk on like Cerati. I love that song. It's just basically talking about love over materialism. That's it. But I love the song. And someone else who endorsed that song for me, Timbaland, you know, he played the song, yes, during his live feed on Instagram.
What?
And I'm like, and everybody's loving the song, and I'm so happy about it.
That is absolutely amazing. Mm-hmm. I think right now there's no more that thing of we're limited to Africa,
Oh, no, the music is spreading, and why I'm so happy about it is happening in our time, and the fact that we don't have to change.
Mm.
I'm African, and I'm selling myself as an African, and the world is accepting it, so.
I love that so much. And now it's time for Quick Fire with Niniola. You have basically two options to choose from, so you should get at least 50% correct.
I should.
You have a 50% chance.
Mm-hmm.
The players you have to choose from today are James Harden.
Okay.
Let's see that you know the, aha, when you get, if you think that that's the answer, you'll put him up to your
point. Okay.
Or Kyrie Irving. Yes. So those are the two things you get to choose from. If you feel like you don't know, just answer like who you think deserves to be the answer to that.
Okay.
Let us go. We're gonna start easy. Which player is famously known as the beard?
Harden.
Correct.
Yay!
Which player has won the scoring title?
Kyrie. Correct.
Incorrect.
Correct.
I'll let you go again using the next question. Which player has won Rookie of the Year?
Kyrie.
Correct. Next question.
Okay.
Which player was born in Australia?
Ah, Danny Ban. Kim?
Yes!
Yay!
Correct. Which player has won an NBA title?
Aneto. Kim.
Correct!
Yay!
You're killing this, actually.
I know.
Wow. Which player was once in the same team as my favorite player, Kevin Durant?
Baby.
Yes! How are you getting this? Which craft is this? I have to tell you, you're really killing this.
I know, yeah.
Let's ask something fashion related.
Okay.
Which one of these two looks like they would have a bigger shoe size?
Okay, so let me check. Small feet. Big feet, so Kyrie.
Incorrect.
No, I was still checking them out, you know.
It actually, he looks like he has bigger feet on this. These
so
guys didn't do a proper measurement. You are absolutely wrong.
So who
wrong.
Did this? I'm coming for you. Okay.
Next question.
No.
This is going to be the funniest interview.
I was confident. I was going to win.
It looks like he has bigger feet. Mm-hmm. I would have thought. Who was the number one overall pick in the NBA draft? I'm dead. Incorrect.
No.
Brilliant. By far the most dramatic quickfire ever. But also the highest scoring.
Yay!
Well done. Nice. You've only had one person to compete with so far. Niniola is definitely leading the score of our quickfire. Who knew that you knew so much about basketball? And now let us check in on seven-time NBA champion Robert Ori as he weighs in on two African giants. I'm talking about Joel Embiid and Pascal Siakam, who are currently going head-to-head in the Eastern Conference semifinals.
Hey, NBA Africa, game time. Here are my thoughts on the matchup between Joel Embiid and Pascal Siakam.
In the opening quarter. Oh, Embiid! Big time! Leonard, the rejection!
Siakam and Joel Embiid. Joel Embiid, extremely great big man on the inside, outside. And Siakam probably he's going to be the most improved player in my book. You know, he took his game to a whole new level this year. He's made the Toronto Raptors who they are. He's carrying, averaging 15 plus points a game. But who can kind of Embiid? One of the funniest guys in the NBA. He knows how to have great fun, but when it comes to having fun on the basketball court, he dominates as a big man. He has great footwork. He's going to be a dominant presence on the inside. So when you have these two Cameroon guys coming together, it's going to be great for Africa. It's going to be great for NBA basketball. It's just great basketball to watch, period.
Wow, those are actually two of my favorite players. I love them both.
Cameroon must be very, very proud.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Big one for Cameroon. But who's going to come out on top? Let us know what you think in the comments below. Is it going to be Embiid with the 76ers? Or is it going to be Siakam with the Toronto Raptors? Now, don't forget, you can catch more NBA playoff action right here on the NBA Africa YouTube channel. On Sunday morning, you can catch the Warriors going up against the Rockets. That's going to be at 2:30 a.m. And then later on at 9:30 p.m., you can catch the 76ers going up against the Raptors on the NBA Africa YouTube channel. So subscribe so that you don't miss anything. As you see, we're really big on sharing here at NBA Africa Game Time. We like to share a word each week in our mother tongue, right?
Okay.
Last week, I told the list how to say ball in Kiswahili, which is mpira.
Mpira.
Can you please teach me something in Yoruba that relates to basketball?
Okay. Steph Curry.
Ebana.
Say it. Ebana. Say Ebana.
So even that is Yoruba, right?
Oh, okay. Yes.
Steph Curry.
Ongba bolu.
Ongba bolu.
Ongba.
Ongba.
Bolu.
Bolu.
Oh.
Yes. Yes. I feel like I just hit a three. Yes. Thank you so much.
Yeah, you tried.
And what does that mean? What have I just said?
It just means Steph Curry plays basketball so well.
Love it. And yeah. It's absolutely true.
Yeah, it is.
Niniola, you're the best. Thank you so much.
Oh, I love you too, darling.
For joining us. And we love you guys too at home. So make sure that you follow NBA Africa on all of our social media. I'm talking Facebook, Twitter, and of course, right here on YouTube, where you should be subscribed already. And if not, do that right now. Till next time, peace.
Bye.